Hello students, welcome to lecture of kinematics and theory of machine. This is the second lecture of this chapter brake, and we are going to learn second type of brake in this lecture, and we will also solve the another example for that type of brake. Okay, so we are going to study the simple band brake. Okay, in last lecture you have learned the shoe brake, and there is a shoe is connected with the wheel and the angle of contact is very small, but in a band brake you can see there is a band is around the drum, and these two ends of that band is connected to lever, and when we apply any force on that lever, the band tighten on the wheel, and what will happen, this friction will be increased, and we can decrease the speed of that drum or we can stop that drum. Okay, you can see here, if we apply the P force on a lever, what will happen when we apply the P force upward direction, you can see that the belt will be tightened, band will be tightened on a drum, and you can see there is a very large angle is there, which is a angle of lap, okay, or angle of contact. Okay, you can see there is a two sides of bands are there, one is a tight side and which is a second is a slack side. It is totally depend upon the direction of the rotation of the drum. If the drum is rotating like in a figure, you can see the clockwise direction, you can say that T1 is a tight side, means band which is connected to B is a tight side, and end of that band or belt which is connected to O, pivot point, it is a slack side, T2. So as it is rotating right now in a clockwise, but if it is rotating in an anticlockwise, the tight side and slack side will interchange, means end which is connected to O will be tight side, and end which is connected to B will be slack side. Okay, this is totally depend upon the direction of the drum. Okay, now as you can see on figure, the length of lever is L, the distance from the pivot point, the band end is connected at a B, which is denoted by small b, and you can see the band is connected from the M point to, you can see the arc up to L point. So this arc is a total angle is given by theta. And okay, let's understand the term in this figure. So T1 is a tight side of the band, T2 is a slack side of the band, and you can see the angle of lap or angle of contact also, you can see theta. Now mu is a coefficient of friction between the drum and the band, and R is a radius of drum, okay, and T is a thickness of that band. Okay, this T, if you consider the T, the drum diameter will be increased by some value, so there is also, we take here the RE is the effective radius of the drum. If you consider the thickness of the band, then we have to consider the effective radius, and if you neglect the thickness of that band, then you directly say the small r, which is the radius of the wheel drum. Okay, now as you know that particular in a belt drive, the T1 at tight side and T2 is slack side, and there is a one relation is there between tight side and slack side, because in a belt drive you also use the friction to transmit the motion, and here you use the friction as a braking force. Okay, so equation will be same, T1 upon T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta, or you can write here in a form of log also. How much braking torque will be applied here? It is a difference between T1 minus T2 into radius. If you consider the thickness of the band, then our formula will be T1 minus T2 into RE. Okay, in a belt drive, torque transmitted is equal to T1 minus T2 into radius of that pulley. Right now in a band brake, you can see the braking torque is equal to T1 minus T2 into radius. If you consider the thickness, you have to take as a RE, T1 minus T2 into RE. Okay, let's take one example. As you can see the given data, a band brake act on a 3/4 of circumference of drum of 450 mm diameter, which is key to shaft. Okay, you can see the belt is surrounded that drum, and this circumference covered by this band is a 3/4 of whole circumference. Okay, The band brake provides the braking torque, means torque braking. TB is already given, 225 Newton into meter, it is given in meter. So if you use the all unit in a mm, then you have to convert this torque into Newton into mm. Now one end of the band is attached to the fulcrum pin of the lever and the other end to the pin at 100 mm. So there is a given 100 mm is a distance between pivot point to the end of the band, which is a small b. Okay, so small b is equal to 100 if the operating force is applied at 500 mm from the fulcrum. So whole distance is given, distance of lever is given, so p is applied at a 500 mm, so l is equal to 500. Okay, coefficient of friction is equal to 0.25. find the operating force when drum rotates in the anti-clockwise and clockwise. So we have to calculate the whole example in a two cases. One is a when the drum is rotating in a anti-clockwise, and second is in a clockwise. Okay, so let's start. So if you want to find the force P, how you can find the force? Because so there is a, you can take the moment with respect to pivot point, P into L and T2 into B. Okay, this is an example totally based on the moment. How many forces you can see in the figure? There is a three forces are there. One is a P, which is we applied on the end of lever. Second is a tight side and slack side. When we want to take the moment about O point, you can see that slack side T1 or T2 depend upon the rotation of the brake, which is passed through the O point. So what will happen? We have to take the moment of any one force here, maybe either tight side or slack side, but we have to take the moment. And if you want to take the moment, first we need to find the T1 and T2, tight side and slack side. How you can find the this tight side and slack side? We have two formulas. One is a torque is equal to T1 minus T2 into radius, and second is a T1 upon T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta. Okay, using these two formula, we can find the T1 and T2, and then we can take the moment with respect to O, and we will find the P force. So we will find the P. Okay, let's start. Let's check the given data. As the diameter is given, diameter of drum is a 450 mm, so radius small r will be 225 mm. In meter, if you want to write in a meter, 0.225 meter will. And torque is given 225 Newton into meter. B is given 100 mm, so it will be 0.1 meter. And length is equal to 500 mm, so it can be write as a 0.5 meter. And coefficient of friction between band and drum is given 0.25. Okay, let's start. So as you can see, first of all, we have to find as a when the drum is rotating in a anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so we have, if you want to find the P, we need to find T1 and T2. So let's start the formula T1 upon T2 e raised to mu. So we will using the 2.3 log T1 upon T2 is equal to mu theta, but we need to find the theta first. And in given data, they said three fourth of the circumference, means total angle is a 360, so 3/4 will be 270, but it is given in a degree. We need to find the theta in a radian. So pi upon 180, we will multiply to that 270, and we will find what we have found here, theta is equal to 0.713 radian. Okay, now you can use that formula, which is a 2.3 T1 upon T2 is equal to mu theta. Okay, in this T1 and T2 unknown, we will put all the data and we will give the equation number 1 as a T1 upon T2. Okay, this equation you can see T1 upon T2 3.253. Now what will be, what we are going to do, we will use the second formula, which is equal to, now we are going to use second formula, which is equal to braking torque is equal to T1 minus T2 into radius. We know the radius, we know the torque. We need to find T1 and T2. We put all the values and we will find the formula, second formula or second equation, which is include T1 and T2. So T1 minus T2, the formula is equal to T1 minus T2 is equal to 1000 Newton. So using this equation number 2 and 1, we can find the T1 and T2. You will put the value of T1 from equation number 1 into equation number 2, and you will find T1 and T2. So check this value of T1 is equal to 1444 newton and T2 is equal to 444 newton. So now we have T1 and T2. We will take the moment of all the forces in a figure, okay, with respect to O. So first force is a P. P into distance to the O is equal to L. So P into L. Second force is equal to T2, means it is a slack side. Okay, you can see the if the drum is rotating in an anti-clockwise, tight side is equal to T1, which is the pass through the O. So we don't need to take the moment with respect to T1 tight side. Okay, just we need to take the moment of the P force and the slack side. So equation will be like this: P into L is equal to T2 into B. Put all this value and you will find the P here. Okay, so P is equal to 88.8 newton if the drum is rotating in a anti-clockwise direction. But now assume that drum is rotating in a clockwise, what will happen? Tight side and slack side will be interchanged. Now the tight side is at a point B and the slack side is at a pivot point. So force which will pass through the pivot point, we don't need to take the moment of that moment force. Okay, just we will take the moment P into L is equal to T1 into B. Now as you can see here, T1 is equal to, put all that value and you will find that P is equal to 288.8 newton. Okay, very basic example. In all the example of band break, we need to find the T1, T2 first and mu and theta. If theta is not given, as in this example, we have to find the theta. But ultimately, we will take the moment which is totally depend upon the figure given in an example. Okay. Thank you. Keep practicing.